102, take one.
With overlap, action please. Action Orson, please.
You just do anything?
No, it's sorry, cut. You're rolling.
102, take two.
Ah, the French champagne has always been celebrated for its excellence. There is a California champagne by Paul Masson, inspired by that same French excellence. It's fermented in the bottle, and like the best French champagne, it's vintage dated. Cut. So Paul Masson.
102, take three.
Action, please.
Ah, the French champagne has always been celebrated for its excellence. There is a California champagne by Paul Masson, inspired by that same French excellence. It's fermented in the bottle, and like the best French champagne, it's vintage dated. So
cut.
Paul Masson soup.
Steamed or grilled hot dogs.
Going, my friend, have you forgotten when there was a time filled with hope instead of fear that's in your heart? There was a time when life was simple and innocent to start. Do you remember? Do you remember? Where you going, my friend? Have you forgotten when there was a time when false information wasn't so rampant in the sphere? There was a time when you weren't questioning everything you hear. Do you remember? Do you remember? Constantly being advertised, your life commercialized and disguised as happiness and pills and potions, fancy threads and cars and motion, hypnotized by gilded lies to line the pockets of so few, while hungry politicians feed bullshit to the masses to ensure their statuses and further divides the classes.
Is in your mind, the revolution is in your mind, the revolution is in your mind.
And now, preview time. When it comes to entertainment, you can't beat a good film.
I took some LSD when I took off with the car. And the next thing I know, there I was out there, you know, high as a Georgia pine, tripping on acid.
The Pirates in a World Series start Doc Ellis.
Doc was basically one hell of a pitcher.
He done a lot of damn good things while he was doing the bad things.
Baseball in that decade really collided with pop culture.
We were a team that was dressed to kill, and Doc, he was flashy.
The old school guys were used to saying, you do it my way.
I remember one time I had my hair braided, and they wanted to know, what is that about? I'm, don't ask me about my hair being braided. Get out of my face.
He called himself the Muhammad Ali of baseball.
You know, the Pirate was loaded with black and Latin players.
His first roommate was with Roberto Clemente.
And I looked, I said, oh my God.
And there's nine brothers out there.
That's the first time it had ever happened.
He realized the racial tensions that were going on in the country. Baseball gave him a platform to speak his mind.
There was a wisdom there. He'd been through a hell of a lot.
Somebody had put three Ks on my door.
They threatened me. If you stick your head over the dugout, we're gonna shoot you. I had my head over the dugout the whole game.
Drugs had really taken over him. I think he thought he was taking them over, but I think it was the other way around.
You know, if Doc's pitching, you know he's high. How high is
he? You're not the only pitcher who's thrown him somewhere, man.
I threw to hit him. I mean, I threw to hurt him bad.
Well, here we are, Doc Ellis working on a no-hitter.
It was easier to pitch with the LSD. That's the way I was dealing with the fear of failure.
He got it. They're mounting Doc Ellis on a no-hitter.
It was an ugly no-hitter. I got letters about it. But it was a no-no.
Right, three.
Hello, I'm a Corvus celestial person from outer space. My real name is Cookie Puss, but my friends call me CP. I'm a Corvel ice cream cake, and I made fresh daily at participating Corvel ice cream stores. Yeah.
Cookie Puss will be at your participating Carvel ice cream stores.
Crispy hot fresh French fries.
Yeah.
You enjoying your summer this summer or what?
No.
No? What's wrong?
And are you?
Oh, I'm doing all right. What's the matter with your summer this summer?
Very boring.
Why is it so boring?
Not enough cute guys around.
Not enough cute guys. You got to go to Glenhead. That's all the cute men, all right?
I love to go to the track, but you work during the day and you don't have time to get to the track. So you come to OTB.
The live calls here at OTB are fantastic because you can see what's going on, you can hear what's going on.
They tell us what scratches are, who the jockeys are, what changes we have. So that we're right up to date as if we were at the track.
If I can't make it here, I usually have my phone account, which all I do is I have my little card here, and boom, I call in, and I have my action from over the phone.
We'll be right back.
And now, preview time. When it comes to entertainment, you can't beat a good film. So let's take a look at what's coming your way.
It's called the repellent fence. And what we are proposing to construct is a 2 mile long ephemeral monument that crosses the border. And so our goal with this is to create a metaphor that acts like a suture. It's like stitching the United States and Mexico together.
Art is supposed to raise questions and jolt you and move into those gaps between art and life that people weren't thinking about much and pry them open and make you see what's going on in a place.
We want to acknowledge that we're not just citizens of the U.S. or citizens of Mexico or citizens of Guatemala. We're indigenous people. We're citizens of the tribes from which we came from.
We really need to talk about the wind.
Whoa! Oh, whoa, 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 whoa!
This just feels like it's just gonna freaking rip.
We can get these balloons to fly for 2 miles, even for 4 hours, 8 hours. You know, we did it.
The cartel knows where everybody lives.
Yeah, they're watching you guys right now. Yeah. We're picking up a lot of scanner traffic.
Can I just say, being raised bi-nationally, doing the dual back and forth, you know, parents, family living in Mexico, then being raised here as well, I am so excited that we have artists like you that challenge the status quo, that challenge everything that we know to be true, and then just erase lines.
She'll get by. She'll get by.
asked about the things to make her day. Sister Elizabeth shined a penny she picked up along the way. The Joker and the Jack of Hearts are always there to do their part. Not so much alone as caught between the hammer and the stone. She'll get by, she'll get by, she'll get by. Pleasant is the valley where we pray. Sister Elizabeth never weary, none for nothing anyway. So I let her take me down, only to find she ain't around. But not so much alone.
Laughing Heart. Your life is your life. Don't let it be clubbed into dank submission. Be on the watch. There are ways out. There is light somewhere. It may not be much light, but it beats the darkness. Be on the watch. The gods will offer you chances. Know them and take them. You can't beat death, but you can beat death in life. Sometimes the more often you learn to do it, the more light there will be. Your life is your life. Know it while you have it. You are marvelous, and the gods wait to delight in you. That's a beauty, you know.
Klein, and your father was Wayne Klein, the singer.
Yeah, what can I do for you?
I'm your sister.
So no one ever told you about me.
So are you a friend of Rose?
No, I'm Mo's sister.
Mama, I'm so sorry. I meant to talk to you before you met her.
Stabbed her in the heart, and the red blood did flow.
She kind of phrases a song like her daddy.
I don't want to get back to his mother that I got strange women laying around in their underwear.
You
You know, when I first got here, I didn't think I was going to like you, but I gave you a chance.
You're the only person left in this world who I share blood with.
What's that for?
I would never hurt you, Mom.
I help you, but you have to be the one. What did you come here for?
All the way back in the 1960s, Major League Baseball was quickly growing more and more in the United States. Over in Houston, Texas, the city was expected to get two new teams under the condition that the city built a covered, air-conditioned stadium. So the city and their enthusiastic mayor set out to build which at the time was the country's first dome stadium. An enormous and impressive engineering feat from architects Herman Lloyd and W.B. Morgan, along with Morris Architects. As construction began in January of 1962, the final design brought the structure to an incredible 18 stories tall, with the dome spanning around 642 feet across and covering around 9.5 acres of land. At the time it was built, the stadium could comfortably hold around 42,000 people and became an outstanding piece of architecture for the city of Houston. By late 1964, and right on its $18 million budget, the stadium was completed, and as the city's new MLB team, the Astros, moved into their new home, the building was given the final name after its new team, the Astrodome.
Calling angels, we have returned the claim of pyramid. Mothership, I am the mothership connection. Get down in 3D, a light air groove. If you hear any noise, ain't nobody but me and the boys. Turn the motherfucker out. Y'all ready to get down out there? If you hear any noise, it's just me. Dipping your hip and come on to the mothership. Doing the loose booty. Give me a little more foot up here. The home of the P-Funk, the bomb. I bet your memory bank don't forget this funk.
You got
this I'm bad. Let me rise. I want everybody to stomp your feet up in the balcony.
Infants. God doesn't have it in him tonight. I can feel it.
Sister sure is popular. She's the second most popular religious figure in America.
God speaks through her.
She was drunk.
Her first husband died mysteriously.
Her flair and her cheap movie flack.
She evaporated.
Did
the disappearance of preacher and showwoman sister Amy Semple McPherson. Where is the beloved preacher?
You need a guide. Hombre.
Hey, yo soy Steve. Este es mi esposa, Dottie.
Your Spanish is wonderful.
Thank you.
You aren't rattled by the disappearance of your ex-wife?
You see, Amy had callings, and she followed them.
She's an onion, and she must be peeled delicately.
I'm just an entertainer, that's all. I tell stories.
Can you hear them call, sister?
Her a voice?
Can you hear them call, Amy? Can you hear them call, sister?
Deliver me, sister!
Can you hear them call, Amy?
She's a woman who's just taking care of herself.
So what do you say? Who here needs to be healed?
What do you reckon, Alan? Hit or a miss?
I've always thought of Shiwadi Wadi as being rather fun. I think it's a nice, pleasant record.
Thank you, Alan. Joan?
Well, to me, it doesn't seem to be terribly modern. I mean, it doesn't seem to have any specific newness about it. It's a bit repetitive. It sounds a bit like many, many songs that I've heard. It leaves me a bit in the middle.
Johnny Rotten?
Rubbish. And the audience agrees, so it's a miss all round.
Johnny Rotten.
God, that ain't the Donna Summers I know. I hate it. It's awful.
Where do you think she's changed?
It was mediocre. Stop.
But if it's not the Donna Summer that
no,
you knew,
I mean,
in what way
I don't deserve no more comment than that.
With a suitcase in my hand, part of a traveling band on the road. Girl,
I wonder what'll happen to that one. Johnny Rotten.
Nothing, it's horrible.
What sort of music do you personally enjoy?
Decent.
Could you maybe give us an example of what you think's decent?
Well, my own stuff for a start.
When I once heard you in an interview saying that one of the things you detested most about the new wave music was that nobody was taking it seriously, but so far you don't seem to have said very much in terms of well-balanced criticism. I just wonder whether you might
I don't get involved in lecturing. I just do it. I don't over-promote. You either like or dislike what I do. I won't ram it down your throats like what happened in the past.
Yeah.
shop at the music stores around here? Did the music that's available there influence your taste in music?
What?
Does the music that's available in the mall influence your taste, what you're going to listen to?
Yeah, in a way. Yeah? Yeah, it depends what kind of music's on. Like, I only listen to disco. Yeah. Or punk.
Yes. Yeah. Punk rocker, huh?
Yeah. Well, not really. It depends.
Yeah.
What kind of record?
Do you really want to know?
Yes.
Neil Diamond.
He likes Neil Diamond.
It's his that song Cracklin' Rose.
Yeah. I remember that. That's about a bottle of liquor.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is. Cracklin' Rose.
Store bought woman.
Yeah.
What kind of music you like to hear?
I basically don't listen to music.
You don't listen to music?
Not really.
Why not?
I don't know. I just never got around to get around to it. She does.
But some people listen to that rock bang
hard
stuff.
The rock and roll?
Hard rock.
Oh, I hate that rock and roll.
New wave.
Somebody's gonna blow himself up here. Do you think he's really gonna do it?
You'll find out when he blows himself up.
Turn the light off.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Straight up, he could come off to the side.
They're both running it.
Taylor Irwin was in ground. He could be in 84 feet. Make that 86.
Put your head down a little bit longer.
Cut it.
Lucky orders. Are you ready? Now the stunt man is lighting it. That is not a safe place, Carolyn. That is not a safe place. The lighter ran out of fluid. We're getting ready. All right, we get in there.
Get ready.
Go.
Professional people working, man. How about professional people working? And the people that are learning the business. I want to tell you one thing. That ain't no joke, boys. It's like being hit by Muhammad Ali, man.
This is your brain. This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
I deserve success. I deserve success. I'm not afraid to
mad balls.
Mad balls, mad balls. Gross for one, gross for all. We play with a mad ball. They're gross, funny, yucky, sick. Mad There's balls. Eight, so you can take your pick. We throw, catch, it's uh-oh fun. There's so much gross in every one.
Gross.
Freaky fun is what they're for.
Mad
There's
balls.
So much ugly, so much more. Gross for one, gross for all. We play with a mad ball.
Mad balls.
We play with a mad ball.
Mad balls.
We play with a mad ball.
Mad balls.
Mad balls.
Freaky fun for everyone.
Little pigs, let me come in.
Despite initially receiving mixed to poor reviews, even so far as earning a Razzie nomination for Worst Director, Stanley Kubrick's The Shining is now revered by many as a filmmaking masterpiece, with the dark and ambiguous ending almost as famous as the movie itself. However, had you seen the film during its first day of limited release, you might have wondered if you were crazy upon additional viewings.
I'm dizzy. I need a doctor.
It's now known that the film originally had a much different ending, as evidenced by the on-set continuity Polaroids and the shooting script itself, in the form of an epilogue in between seeing Jack frozen in the snow and the final shot of the mysterious photograph.
Good evening, Mr. Torrance. Good evening.
The scene involved the hotel manager informing Wendy at the hospital that the police couldn't find Jack's body or evidence of anything out of the ordinary, raising more questions than answers. And while initially settling upon the scene's inclusion, immediately after The Shining premiered on May 23, 1980, he decided to cut the ending from the film, having preferred the reaction from an audience without it. But since it was already playing at half a dozen or so theaters in both the New York and Los Angeles area, early in the morning on the second day of the film's debut, Kubrick contacted an assistant editor named Jay Friedkin, along with an unknown Los Angeles counterpart, to physically cut the scene from the reels at each location. And by the first showing on the second day of the film's release, the scene was gone.
That is, quite a story.
Despite being one of the most sought-after lost scenes in cinema history, concrete information about the fate of the cut ending has never come forth, and it is believed that all copies of the scene were destroyed with its removal, or at the request of Stanley Kubrick upon his death. But even if an uncut print exists, much like the cut 17 minutes of footage from 2001 A Space Odyssey, it's doubtful it would ever be released.
I'm afraid that's something I cannot allow to happen.
Here again, the time of year that comes to bring us all good cheer. Picture goers, we bring to you new films of interest to view, both short and long with intermission and brilliant panoramic vision. To make you thoughtful, sad or gay, there never was a better way. For the next 12 months to come, we hope to see both Dad and Mum. We wish you luck and season's greetings and hope for many happy meetings.
The chief of police, he's going to storm the building.
Rock and roll high school, the school where the students rule.
So many 20, 24 hours to go. I want a piece of it. Got up to do nowhere to go. I want a piece of it. Give me to the airport, put me on a plane. Hurry, 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 before I go insane. I can't control my fingers, I can't control my brain. Oh no, oh no.
disagree, however, on Rock and Roll High School, the punk rock movie. I thought it was all good, terrific summertime fun, a lot of good times with a lot of energy. Roger thought it was a near miss. I say yes, he gives it an affectionate no.
I just want something real to happen to me for once.
Oh! Guy, you look so beautiful tonight.
Think so?
Totally.
So you guys picked real winners for prom dates.
Stop! You ruined everything!
I swear. This is all I know.
Well, we're going to the Honor Farm. This old abandoned prison. And we've got shrooms.
Two people died out there freshman year. You guys never heard about that?
No.
It's like everything but now is a dream. Because you can never know what will happen. That's why they shut down the place back in the day.
Her feet go down the deck. The steps lead straight to the grave.
Lucy.